So far, we have been talking about rearrangements in unichromosomal genomes. But of course, mammalian genomes are multichromosomals. And we now want to look at more complex scenarios of rearrangements in multichromosomal genomes. You may be surprised that we are moving to seemingly more difficult case without even a clue on how we would address a simpler case of sorting by reversal in the case of unichromosomal genome. But as you will see, it turned out that rearrangements of multichromosomal genomes are actually, counterintuitively, is a simpler problem. We'll start from some example of rearrangements in tumor genomes, and we'll talk about Philadelphia chromosome. So these are normal chromosomes 9 and 22 in human, and they have genes called ABL and BCR located at this chromosome. Now, consider a break in two places, on the, one on each of these chromosomes, that separate each chromosome into two. This is not unlike two breaks that reversals do, but in this case, these two breaks are applied to different chromosomes. And then afterwards, consider gluing these segments in a new order, resulting in new chimeric chromosomes. As a result, something happened. Genes ABL and BCR that were located at different chromosomes in normal human genomes are now located at the same chromosome next to each other. And as a result, it destroys the regulation of these genes and lead to disease called chronic myeloid leukemia, or CML. It's actually this fusion, oncogenic fusion gene is a hallmark of CML. So from a computational perspective, the operation that I just showed you is called translocation, and it exchange segments of different chromosomes between each other, and thousands of different rearrangements and many translocations are known for different tumors. Knowledge about these rearrangements is very important for studies of cancer. In particular, the ABL-BCR fusion genes in CML, since biologists knew how it looks like, it enabled development of a very efficient cancer drug called Gleevec. And so far, I showed you an example when a single rearrangement leads to a disease. In reality, for many tumors, the situation is more complex. Here, I showed you an image resulting from a technique called chromosome painting. And as a result of this chromosome painting, every chromosome in normal cell should be painted by a single color. There is unique color for every normal human chromosome. However, if you start chromosome painting on tumor genome, and in this case, this is MCF7, human breast cancer cell line, that you see very colorful pictures. This colorful picture illustrates that hardly any chromosome remain intact in MCF7, since every chromosome consists of different pieces, sometimes two, three, even four pieces of different human chromosome combined together. And it's a very difficult question to figure out what sequence of rearrangements has produced the MCF7 tumor genomes. We will, in the next section, we will look at operation on multichromosomal genomes that include not only translocations, but also fusions and fissions. For example, fusion simply combine two chromosomes, glue them together, and fission break a chromosome into two. For example, humans have 23 chromosomes, but chimpanzee, orangutan, and gorilla have 24 chromosomes, because a few million years ago, two chromosomes in human chimpanzee ancestors were fused together into a single chromosome in human. And in the next section, we will look at the algorithmic problem that is called the two-break distance to address the question of how to find rearrangements in multi-chromosomal genomes.